Congratulations on getting your Shopify account connected and set up. Please don't skip this video as it contains really important information on how our Shopify integration works and what you need to do next. Firstly, Shopify works differently from our Amazon, eBay, and Etsy integrations. Shopify allows sellers to use its own payment gateway, Shopify Payments, as well as lots of other third-party payment gateways too, such as PayPal, Klarna, etc. Also, Shopify can be used as a point of sale or POS system too. It's because of this that we've had to split your sales by payment gateway. For any orders paid via Shopify Payments, Link My Books will generate a summary invoice for each payout you receive from Shopify, meaning for each deposit into your bank, there will be a corresponding invoice to match against it. These summaries break down all your sales, refunds, and fees, plus any VAT, GST, or sales tax. All you need to do is send the summary generated by Link My Books to Xero or QuickBooks and then match it against the deposit into your bank account. For any orders paid via third-party payment gateways, such as PayPal or Klarna, etc., Link My Books will generate a monthly summary of the sales and refunds for each payment gateway. Unlike Shopify payment summaries, these other payment gateway summaries only break down your sales, refunds, and any VAT, GST, or sales tax. They do not include a breakdown of any fees charged directly by the third-party payment provider themselves. This is because Link My Books connects to Shopify and not directly with each of these other payment gateways, so we are unable to retrieve the fee information. These monthly summaries will be cleared through a clearing account, one clearing account per payment gateway. We use clearing accounts to record the funds that are expected from each third-party payment gateway, which have not yet been deposited into your bank account. To reconcile these payment gateway clearing accounts, please follow these three steps. Step 1. Send the Link My Books settlement summary report to Xero or QuickBooks. This will debit the clearing account with the net value of your sales minus any refunds via that payment gateway. Step 2. Allocate any deposits from the payment gateway to the relevant payment gateway clearing account. This will credit the clearing account. We name all payment gateway clearing accounts clearly, so it should be easy to identify which is which. Step 3. Download your monthly fees invoice from each payment gateway and account for those directly in Xero or QuickBooks separately. Now, come the end of the month, there can sometimes be a balance left in the clearing account, but that's nothing to worry about. This is usually down to funds yet to be deposited into your bank account for sales that occurred during that month. If you're using the PayPal bank feed, then you should allocate the money received from Shopify orders on the bank feed to the clearing account and the PayPal fees to a PayPal fees account that you have set up in Xero or QuickBooks. We have two great help articles which take you through the above step by step, so please take the time to read them and familiarize yourself with the process. They are linked below this video. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video and learn about how to reconcile your Shopify sales. If you have any follow-up questions after watching this or reading the help articles, then please reach out to the support team who will be happy to help you.